In the Huang household, it's the little things that count.
They have a good collection and they really enjoy playing with them.
Playtime, small talk.
Which one's that from? Is that from Harry Potter?
Oh, that's Ariel.
And often it's those small things that make the biggest difference.
Don't know what happened, but after all this money we spend, it's still, you know, empty.
He's talking about what was meant to go here. Last year, Jonah paid for a cabin to be built, just smaller than a tiny home.
We look at other options like extending the house, but that was just out of budget and it's quite time-consuming as well.
But that tiny project caused the Huangs major loss. It was meant to be a sleep out for his daughters.
We put a lot of trust in the whole process and we thought we were in good hands, but it's very heartbreaking.
House prices in Aotearoa have dipped recently. On average, you'd still be forking out just over $1 million, closer to 1.5 in Tāmaki Makaurau. So we're seeing some creative alternatives.
I've lived in and out of tiny houses for the last 9 years.
Shay Boddington, a Commonwealth Games diver, just quietly, now runs her own tiny homes business.
It's got everything a big home would have in a compact space.
It's less about having space and more about how you use it.
If you design it properly, it doesn't feel like a compromise and it works so well.
Service, please.
Joan is a designer of sorts too.
I'm the head chef of the Odette's Eatery at Auckland City Works Depot.
He's used to building menus and picking the best ingredients, so he was particular about designing his own cabin too.
A lot of tiny homes were prefabbed, and they were kind of coming a set, in a, you know, there's not much you can change around the structure of the things. We look about 4 or 5 companies and Refab's the one that kind of goes, yeah, nothing's too hard for us, no, we'll make this work.
Jonah's talking about Refab Cabins in Auckland, owned by Andrew Sorensen. You may have heard of him before. Well, let me see your hips. A former film and television producer, his production company is responsible for these music videos.
You know, supporting locals, supporting Kiwi small businesses, kind of things that I like to do. There was 4 reviews posted online, they were all 5 stars, and we thought, oh, this fine.
Plus, Refab Cabins are advertised as being built with materials from Auckland's construction waste, so that scored points with Jonah too.
They were saying, once you pay the deposit, we will get your cabin built within 3 months.
The total price for the cabin was just under $75,000. This was for a 2-bedroom, bathroom, open plan, 20 square metre cabin. In June last year, Jonah paid a 30% deposit of around $22,500. It was too good to be true.
Eventually, the sales rep just stopped replying my emails.
And then in August 2021, lockdown meant tools down.
Between the lockdown and the time we paid a deposit, there was 7 weeks of time and nothing was done.
I think there's a lot of people using COVID as an excuse, but as somebody in construction, I so appreciate a little bit of flexibility from our clients and a little bit of understanding.
Shay says it all comes down to communication.
I'm not perfect, I'm constantly learning. We had some clients recently that expressed that they'd wanted more communication from me, and that kept me up at night, but I think that's the thing, is you hear feedback, you make a change.
After failed attempts to try to get hold of Refab and Andrew, Jonah found he wasn't the only one who'd been having issues with the company.
We start getting a bit panicked. Then this Google review from Vincent came out.
Last year, Vincent Heringer paid just over $22,000 for his cabin. After a period of confusing communication from Andrew and then lockdown, he visited the site to find this. And if it wasn't already obvious, a building report confirmed the cabin was poorly built, non-compliant with the building code, and needed a lot more time and money to repair. And another customer, Peter Grills, eventually got his $26,000 cabin completed. But he says it took 10 months of back and forth with Andrew. He says his cabin was also the product of shoddy workmanship, but Peter was able to get the Refab team to complete it to standard. Fair Go got in touch with Andrew to ask about the delays.
Andrew Sorensen said his lawyer would be in touch, but he hasn't told us who that is, and no one's called us yet. We do know that his Greylin office is permanently closed, and a look at the Refab Cabin's website tells us it's under construction.
And just when we thought we weren't going to hear from him, Andrew Sorensen emailed Fairgo saying that he disagreed with some of the complaints in the story.
Like many fledgling enterprises, we've encountered teething problems as we've grown. We were significantly impacted by the lockdown in Auckland. We are always striving to improve our customers' experience, regardless of the circumstances. We unreservedly apologise for poor communications. We're actively focusing on improving in this area.
Vincent is pursuing legal action. It's how Jonah at least got some of his money back. They settled out of court after a lot of chasing from his lawyer.
Out of the 22,500, we got back about 9,000, so there's a loss about 13.5.
To protect yourself, Shay says make sure you know who you're getting into a contract with before you agree to anything.
What I would suggest looking out for is look into that person's history, the director's history. Have they liquidated a lot of companies? Have they had a lot of companies? How long have they been operating for? Do they have qualified builders that they work with? And do they have a workshop that they're happy for you to come and view?
She says pay attention to the images the company uses on their websites and brochures too.
If there's no real pictures of what you're getting for your money, if there's only digital renders, that's a big red flag. Ask them, can I bring a builder around to check out what you're doing?
Jonah's content that at least it wasn't a total loss, but has a message for Andrew.
Are you going to keep on doing this? Get your act together.